In this video, we will see how to use HealthBot playbooks to monitor and identify anomalies in the system kernel to detect BGP session flaps due to gencfg blobs and KRT IO errors. One of the use cases was to detect when the iBGP sessions flapped as the router encountered enomem errors returned from kernel when the limit of gencfg blobs in kernel was reached. When a new RSVP LSP instance was signaled due to bandwidth change, LDP allocated a new stats ID GRP for the LDP ingress route using the RSVP LSP for LDP tunneling. However, LDP failed to release references to gateway stats ID GRP in the next hops template. Hence, the stats ID GRP would not be freed and kept accumulating. Eventually, this would lead to enomem errors returned from kernel when the limit of kernel gencfg blobs was reached, which is set to 2 million. HealthBot default playbook are available to detect BGP session flaps and gencfg blobs if KRT IO error write count is not increasing, or if KRT async and operations queues count is increasing. System KRT API's playbook has four rules which monitor KRT statistics and detects anomalies with respect to IO write errors, async operations, and KRT queues. System kernel vmstats playbook periodically collects VM statistics from Juniper router and detects anomaly in case any of the VM state item used memory reaches limit. System CPU mem KPI's playbook monitors system processes, CPU, and memory, and notifies anomalies. BGP session KPI playbook detects BGP session flaps and notifies anomalies. All these playbooks are deployed on device group core. The status of this group can be seen on the dashboard. Click on R0 to check device health of router R0. Here, device R0 is healthy with respect to BGP session states, system kernel VM stats, system KRT, and process CPU and memory. Let us recreate the problem scenario using sysctl by increasing the gencfg blobs. We will add about 0.5 million gencfg blobs in bulk. This is identified by HealthBot as gencfg anomaly. Here you can see the anomalies. That is gencfg used memory 0.5 million, which crosses medium threshold limit, and hence the tile color is changed to yellow. This is represented in the event timeline as well. Let's add another 0.5 million gencfg blobs. Gencfg used memory continues to increase to 1 million, and this change is read by HealthBot. Further incrementing the gencfg blobs above the high threshold limit. Finally, if gencfg used memory reaches 2 million, which is the configured high threshold limit, anomaly is set to red. We can see the related impact on KRT and iBGP sessions, such as KRT queues show stuck, iBGP neighbor session flap count increases. The progressive change of this scenarios is also seen in the timeline view. That's how you can detect and correlate system kernel gencfg blobs and KRT IO anomalies using HealthBot.